In the grim world of the Necromunda Underhive, the Palanite enforcers are the law, stamping out criminal organisations with their iron-shod boots and delivering the Emperor's justice with big guns. We've had loads of requests to show you guys how to paint the black and yellow armour as seen on the front cover of the Palanite Enforcers Patrol box set, so in this video we're going to show you how to do exactly that. Now, to prepare our model for painting, we've already undercoated it here with Chaos Black Spray, and the first thing we're going to do is show you how to paint the black armour sections. It's going to be a bit unusual here because the base coat we're going to apply is Dark Reaper, and that's actually a layer paint, not a base paint, but it's the right colour to use in this situation. So grab your medium layer brush and let's get started. So we're going to take a little bit of Dark Reaper out of the pot like so, and as always we're going to apply it to our palette here and just add a little bit of water from our pot just to thin it down to make it go onto the model a little easier. There we go, perfect. Then onto the miniature, we're just going to apply Dark Reaper all over the sections of the armour we want to be black. This might seem unusual, but it will make sense eventually, don't worry. Now if you're unsure as to which bits want to be black and which bits want to be yellow, just have a good look at the box set. And there we go, we've applied the Dark Reaper base coat all over the black sections of the armour, and it's time now to move on to the next stage. And the next stage is again a little unusual, because here we're going to be using a contrast paint, Black Templar, all over the Dark Reaper base coat. Normally, of course, you'd use contrast paint over Wraithbone or Grey Seer, but here we're going to use it over a Dark Reaper base coat. So again, grab your medium layer brush and let's get to it. So we're going to take a little bit of the Black Templar out of the pot like so, and onto our palette. We're not going to water this down at all, just making sure there's not too much paint on the brush. Perfect. Then onto our miniature, we're going to apply Black Templar quite heavily all over the Dark Reaper base coat. Make sure you're applying it all over and move the paint around as you're doing so to avoid any areas of pooling. Give it about 20 minutes for it to fully dry. And there we go, the Black Templar has dried, giving this really cool off-black subtle sheen to the armour. So the next thing we're going to do is start adding the highlights onto the armour, and first of all we're going to start off with Dark Reaper again to provide a nice chunky highlight on the edge of the armour. Then we're going to move on to highlights of Thunderhawk Blue, Fenrisian Grey and Blue Horror respectively. Now for this we're going to want a little bit more control over our paint, so I'm going to be using a small Artificer layer brush for really smooth lines. You can use a small layer brush if you'd like to, but I find the small Artificer brush gives you even more control. So let's move on to the Dark Reaper. I'm going to take a little bit of paint out of the pot like so and onto our palette like this. Again, we're going to add a bit of water here, maybe a bit more than before, to make the paint a little thinner, to make it really control and flow onto the model a little easier. Perfect. Then, onto the miniature. So here, we're providing highlights onto the very edges of the armour. So anywhere where there's an absolute sharp edge, provide a nice chunky highlight on the edge, like so. See on the helmet here, we're moving it around like this. And on the front, we'll show you as well. Basically, the very edges of the armour. Because the Black Templar and the Dark Reaper underneath provide a nice subtle sheen, this is going to blend in nice and easily to the edges of the armour. Now, sometimes you might want to add reflective spots. You see on the front cover of the box set, on the top bit of the armour here, I'm going to add a deliberate blob going into the armour like so. We're going to highlight this up later on to make it look like a light is shining off that particular part of the armour. There we go, highlight around all the black areas of the armour. Once that's done, it's time to move on to the next highlight. The next highlight we're applying is Thunderhawk Blue. This is going on a little bit thinner than the previous highlight of Dark Reaper and is going inside the highlights like so. Again, apply this around all the edges of the armour and make sure you don't forget to apply it onto the insides of the light reflection blobs we've painted here as well. The next highlight we're applying is Fenrisian Grey. This time we want a really super fine highlight just along the very edges of the armour. So we've thinned it down to make it nice and thin, and again we're using our small Artificer layer brush for extra control. As neat as you possibly can here, to try and make those highlights really razor sharp. The last highlight we're applying to the black armour is Blue Horror. Here we're actually using small dots and applying it to very vertices. So a spot highlight, which is here and here, and other areas where armour joints meet together. Also, we're going to put it onto the light reflection up here as well. And there we go, with the Blue Horror highlight complete, the black armour sections are done. So now it's time to move on to the yellow armour sections, and for this we're going to follow a very similar process. We're going to start off with a base coat of Avalon Sunset applied to all the areas of the armour we want to be yellow. For this we're going back to our medium layer brush, so let's get to it. We're going to take a little bit of paint out of the pot as before, and again we're going to be thinning it on our palette like so. Just want to make sure the paint's a little thin to make sure it goes onto the model a little easier. Perfect. Then onto our enforcer, we're just going to apply the paint very carefully to all the sections of the armour we want to be yellow. Now here we're painting a yellow base coat over black, so you might find you need a couple of coats to go on nice and solid colour, but that's absolutely normal, so we're going to go a couple of thin coats here just get a really nice colour. And there we go, the Avalon Sunset stage all over the armour is complete, so now it's time to move on to the next stage. And again, we're going to be using a contrast paint. This time I end in yellow all over the yellow sections of the armour. Again, grab your medium layer brush and let's get to it. So again, we're going to take a little bit of iron and yellow out of the pot like so, just onto the palette like this. We're making sure we're not overloading the brush because they're quite small sections of armour. We want to make sure there's not too much paint on there. Perfect. There we go. And now onto the miniature. We're just going to apply it very carefully all over the yellow sections of the armour. You'll notice it's going to apply a natural shade in some of the recesses and also really bring out that rich yellow colour. And there we go, the iron and yellow has dried on the armour, giving this really cool shaded effect. So now it's time to move on to the highlighting stage, and for this we're going to use three paints. First of all, we're going to start off with Uriel Yellow, then we're going to highlight with Flashgits Yellow, and finally Phalanx Yellow. Again, we're going back to our small Artificer layer brush here for added control. So let's take a little bit of the Uriel Yellow out of the pot like so, and add it onto our palette here. We're adding a little bit of water, just to make sure the paint's thinned down a little bit, and the highlights are super thin. Perfect. Then, onto our miniature. We're going to be applying very thin line highlights to the edges of all the yellow panels of armour. So make sure you're super careful as possible and try and be as thin as you can. Make sure you're not hitting any of the black areas of armour you painted before. The next highlight we're applying is Flashgits Yellow. Again, we're using a small Artificer layer brush and being very careful just to hit the very edges of each of the yellow armour panels. And the last highlight we're applying is Phalanx Yellow. Again, applying very lightly to the edges of the yellow armour panels. So there we go, with the final highlight complete, the armour of our Palanite Enforcer is complete. Remember, using contrast paints in the way we've seen in this video is unusual, but you can use them over different colours to get some really cool effects. Try it yourself. Happy painting.